We've all heard that oral health and whole body wellness are connected, but new research tells us that people with poor dental health tend to have more general health problems, not surprising. Well, with us today, Michelle Strange, dental hygienist, is here with us. Thank you so much for joining
us. Absolutely.
Welcome, Michelle.
Thank you.
I have to tell you that I brushed my teeth a few times, did a little flossing. I get really nervous in front of dental hygienists. I don't know what it is.
Well, it's okay. We look, but we do not judge,
oh,
I promise.
Good. Good to know. Okay, so I have to ask you, what, in your opinion, are the main causes of poor dental health? And do you think there's this mind-body connection?
I think there's a slight bit of a mind-body connection. If you're a real anxious person or you suffer from anxiety, you can grind your teeth a little bit more. If you're suffering from depression, you probably aren't taking good care of your whole body, including your oral health. But I think that's just the tip of the iceberg, really, because there's such a correlation these days with studies showing us that systemic health and poor oral health are so linked. Mm-hmm. So it is just the tip of the iceberg.
I know we've all heard the saying, the eyes are a window to the soul, but so are the teeth and gums.
Oh, yes.
Because the appearance of the teeth and gums not only tells us about how we take care of them and ourselves, but also they may reveal an underlying health condition, both physical or mental.
Talk to me a little bit about these general health conditions.
Well, there's a large body of data linking periodontal disease or disease of the teeth and gums and bone with other health conditions such as heart disease, diabetes, even cancer.
Yes.
The link is that bacteria that live in the mouth and that may cause inflammation there may also spread to other parts of the body and cause problems as well.
And it's also whatever is occurring in the body can affect the mouth, because if you're taking certain medications for some of these systemic diseases, they can give you dry mouth, which is known as xerostomia, which can increase your decay rate. If you suffer from acid reflux, you can actually increase your amount of cavities in your mouth because of all the acid.
So what I'm hearing from you is that really taking care of our teeth is more than just having a pretty smile.
There's also this issue of inflammation, inflammation in the mouth. Can stimulate inflammation in other parts of the body. And that's important because inflammation is one of the causes of cancer.
Inflammation begins in between the teeth, and it is what destroys the bone which the teeth sit in, so we have to control it.
So can you tell us, Michelle, what would you recommend as a daily dental routine?
Well, brushing first and foremost, and doing it for at least 2 minutes. None of this quick little 30 seconds in and out, and we go about our day. Brushing is where we start, but really and truly, it's only going to clean about 60% of our teeth. We really have to remember that we have to get in between our teeth because that is where the inflammation
starts.
What
about flossing?
Flossing, it's difficult. I mean, not everybody can do it. And some people, they use floss, no problems, but other people have larger spaces in between their teeth. And then that's where this line by Tepe comes in.
And I just want to stop you for one moment, because going back to the brushing and the toothbrushes, I see you have them here. I don't think I'm the only one that gets overwhelmed when I have to buy a toothbrush. There's so many. Is it an individual thing, or is there general recommendations?
Well, just overall, you want to make sure you have a soft bristle. Gone are the days of a hard or medium bristle, because then you start to brush too hard. We also want to make sure we don't have that.
I think that's my problem. One of my problems.
Well, people like to do this like white knuckle grip on the brush.
So true.
I mean, we just want a light pressure, but the bristles, they're the main function. And you want a nice little tapered bristle, and you want to be able to hold it well, which is what is so great about this Tepe brush here. You can really grab it.
This one is so incredibly soft.
So is this one.
It is. It
Not for everyone, though.
No, and there's some that are made for after surgery, but your everyday brush should just be a soft bristle brush.
And the teeth is so fine at the end.
It's beautiful.
Yes.
Absolutely. Really
yes.
It.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay, so now we've dealt with the outside, but really the more important part is what happens
in between the teeth.
And it's so hard to access. Yes, there's flossing, but there's more.
There's definitely more. It's very hard to, as a hygienist, to say, everyone brush and floss. Because one, you might not be able to hold the floss, you might not have very good fine motor skills, get your hands in the way back. Plus, you might also have larger spaces in between your teeth, and you need a little something extra when you get into those larger spaces. So that's why this line by Tepe, it comes in all different sizes. And they're nice and pretty, but they're not just beautiful colors. The colors actually mean something. They're sized. So it's not one size fits all. So you can't just go to the store and grab your little tiny brush and think that that's gonna fit everywhere.
What does a different length mean? I'm interested in knowing that.
Sometimes it's just for dexterity. You have this size where you can grab it. It comes with a cap. You can put it on the back. It actually lengthens the handle a little bit. This, if you need to grab it, like we have dexterity issues as we age with arthritis and things like that.
But these are called interdental brushes. The Tepe Interdental Brushes.
Correct.
Absolutely fabulous. And really, I've used them. We were all sort of bummed trying to grab them after lunch.
I feel like I need to take a dental break now.
This one feels about right for me, but there's a big one over
here.
There's a big one there.
Interested. And everybody's a little afraid of this
big one.
But, you know, sometimes we lose a natural tooth and we have a large gap. This fits perfectly in that area.
Okay.
So this is why I was saying it's just not one size fits all, because we all have certain parts of our mouth that, I mean, we have a space here, we have a missing tooth there, maybe have a little crowding in the front.
So can we use these for braces, bridges, and dental implants as well?
These actually make lives so much easier around those certain dental appliances. But the great thing about this line is that they are plastic coated, the wire is, so you can use them around implants without harming the titanium implant.
Oh.
And the thing a lot of people forget about implants is they can fail. They can have disease around them. They will never decay, which is great, but you can have bone disease and gum disease, also known as peri-implantitis, and they can fail, and you can lose that very costly implant.
Proper cleaning.
Yes.
Okay. And when do I know that I have a real issue, though, doctor?
Well, if someone is having persistent bleeding that doesn't recover after a few days of proper care, I think they should consider maybe that there's another problem, and sometimes there's a link, as we've said so far, between dental disease and other conditions.
Yes.
For example, did you know that poor dental health is as strong a predictor of heart disease as your cholesterol level?
Well, we're going to try to prevent any of that by doing the right thing. I've got my tool, my two new tools.
Please, for your hygiene.
That's for you. That's for you. Thank you so much, doctor, of course, and thank you, Michelle,
thank you for joining us.
Thank you. You'll find much more information about Tepe Interdental Brush on our website, accesshealth.tv. So keep up the good attitude and go brush up that smile, please.